बोलने का मौका दिया। अध्यक्ष महोदय, टीडीपी से मैं अकेले बोल रहा हूँ, तो मुझे पूरा जो अलॉटेड टाइम है वो पूरा करने दे, यही आपसे।
अलॉटेड टाइम में ही पूरा कर,
अलॉटेड टाइम में पूरा करेंगे।
उल्टा बोलो, अलॉटेड टाइम में ही,
अलॉटेड टाइम में ही पूरा करेंगे मैडम, जितना भी हमारे पार्टी को अपने नंबर के हिसाब से मिलना चाहिए। थैंक यू मैडम स्पीकर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू स्टैंड इन सपोर्ट ऑफ दी प्रोटेस्ट दैट आर ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड आवर बिलव्ड लीडर नारा चंद्रबाबू नायडू जी हैज बीन डूइंग इन दिल्ली in AP Bhavan, madam, for the rights of this state of Andhra Pradesh and to save democracy in this nation in these difficult times. And also, madam speaker, it has been 5 years. The first time I came into this parliament was with a lot of hope, that a new government has come in, a lot of hope that a prime minister who has come to Andhra Pradesh during the elections has promised so many things, including the special status for Andhra Pradesh, for actual implementation of the rightful Act, AP Reorganization Act for the state of Andhra Pradesh. And also, madam, when I first came to Delhi, when I saw him, that he has bowed before the parliament, our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, when he bowed before the parliament, when he touched the steps of the parliament, then I was very hopeful, young parliamentarian, thinking that there would be a lot of justice being done in this current term. But today, madam, I stand in total contrast to my feelings which I have expressed, which I have had 5 years ago. Madam, if the house remembers, at that time when I have taken the oath, I was wearing white clothes, madam, when I was speaking. And today, in that sense also, I am in total contrast and I am wearing black as a sign of protest against this central government, madam, which has not even fulfilled one single assurance which has been given in the act. And this is not just a baseless allegation that I am making. This is with reality that I am speaking, madam. The current situation that Andhra Pradesh is going on, there has been nothing that has been done by the central government. And if you consider, madam, some of the demands that we have put in, and even the budget, there has been a lot of confusion. Every time there has been a tradition that has been followed that it has to be a vote on account budget. And even in the business that has come out, it says that it's a vote on account budget. But when they speak about it, they say it is an interim budget. And when he presents the budget, it comes out to be a full-fledged budget. Why is there so much confusion? Why is it that they can't stick with the general democratic tradition of having a vote on account budget? What has compelled them to put in a full-fledged budget, to put in like a account on vote budget where they have to bring in all these jumlas, where they have to bring in so many schemes to woo the farmers, to woo the youth and all these things? This is a sign that the present government is afraid of not coming back again. So with that sense, they have put in a budget where they want to woo the vote and nothing else, madam. And when it's coming, when I come back to the demands of the state of Andhra Pradesh, one of the priority of our demands has been the special status for Andhra Pradesh, madam. And I have to reiterate, अभी यहाँ पे जितने भी लोग हैं उन सबको लगता होगा कि आंध्रा ही है क्या, ये हर बार प्रोटेस्ट ही करते रहते हैं, पर आप एक बार हमारे दर्द को समझेंगे और हम जिस तरह से प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं, हमारे जो मांगे हैं उन सबको अगर समझेंगे, तो आपको ये भी यकीन होगा कि आंध्रा भी इस देश में है। यही हम समझाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं मैडम बार बार, जो हमारे हक हैं, वॉट एवर राइट्स हैव बीन प्रॉमिस्ड फॉर द स्टेट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश, इज दैट व्हाट वी आर आस्किंग फॉर। वी आर नॉट आस्किंग फॉर एनीथिंग मोर। वॉट एवर वी हैव बीन आस्किंग इज समथिंग विच हैज बीन प्रॉमिस्ड बाय द प्रीवियस सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, by the previous prime minister and the present prime minister also, who has come to Andhra Pradesh before becoming a prime minister. And when he has promised the special status for Andhra Pradesh, he has said the state of Andhra Pradesh needs special status not just for 5 years but for a term of 10 years, and I am going to grant it to the state of, that is what he has promised, madam. Now he has not fulfilled that promise and he has taken a U-turn twice on that very promise, madam. When we have asked for special status, then he has said that 14th finance commission has rejected for it, whereas there has been no rejection for a special status to be given. There was only a recommendation. When this honorable prime minister can implement demonetization, which is affecting 130 crore people of this country, when he can take a decision single-handedly to take such an immense task on himself, why can't he grant special status for Andhra Pradesh, which is benefiting 5 crore people of this country, madam? Why hasn't he taken that decision? Why has to bring in an excuse over there? And once we have started demanding for special status, other than giving the 14th Finance Commission excuse, he has misled the state people of Andhra Pradesh. He has misled the country, saying that the state which have been already getting special status will not get any more benefits after 2015, madam, which is also wrong. I state the facts in front of this house that all the benefits that the states of Northeast have been getting under the special status name, they are being continued, madam. But that has been not granted for the state of Andhra Pradesh. And they have announced special package, and what have they done in that? They have presented 2-3 budgets after that special package has been announced. Not a single paisa has been given for Andhra Pradesh under the special package, madam. And when we started demanding on that, when we started putting pressure on the special package also, then they have said that now this is not possible, now we are going to take a U-turn, please consider for special purpose vehicle, madam. So every time we have been asking for special status, हमें गुमराह करने की कोशिश किया गया, एक के बाद एक दूसरा एक्सक्यूज देकर आज तक नहीं दिया मैडम. 2014 में देने वाला था, आज तक नहीं मिला मैडम. अगर 2014 में 5 साल के लिए विशेष राज्य का दर्जा हमें दे देते, आज हमें ये प्रोटेस्ट करने की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ती मैडम. आज हमें वेल में खजाने की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ती. क्यों नहीं दिया गया? आज तक ये सवाल का समाधान इनसे नहीं मिला मैडम. एक और चीज जो रेलवे जोन की बात आती है, आई एम हैप्पी दैट दी ऑनरेबल railway minister also, who is acting as the finance minister, he is also present here. He knows the entire situation. In fact, when we went to him asking for the railway zone, it is him who has said that there is a problem with the Odisha people. And now Bhartra Hariji is also here, who is will obviously go on record and say that Odisha has no problem in granting railway zone for Andhra Pradesh. You just make to both the states sit together, you just see a boundary which can be drawn between the two states and grant the railway zone. But even till now, madam, not a single meeting has been set up. Not a single meeting has been done in terms of railway zone. They are just putting it back because we are protesting, because we are asking for our rights. Is it wrong? अगर हम अपने राज्य के हक के लिए अगर यहाँ पे मांग करेंगे तो ये गलत बात है. कल हमारे प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी आंध्र में गुंटूर आते हैं और क्या बोलते हैं वहां पे? बोलते हैं कि नारा चंद्रबाबु नायडू जी चीफ मिनिस्टर है, मेरे को गाली देते हैं. किस तरह से बातें कर सकते हैं? ये हमारे गौरव की बात है कि एक प्रधानमंत्री इस तरफ से बातें करें. When our Chandrababu Naidu ji has said nothing, madam, nothing personal about the Prime Minister. He has not alleged any of the personal attacks. He has just asked to implement the AP Reorganization Act. He has just asked to give us our rightful justice. And he comes to Andhra Pradesh, he comes to Guntur, and the kind of allegations, personal attacks he has done on Chandrababu Naidu ji, on his family, is very degrading, madam, not just for him, but also the position of the Prime Ministership, madam. And I reiterate my demand of railway zone once again in this very house. There is an immediate need to grant railway zone, madam. That is the lifeline for the Uttar Andhra region, the northern region of Andhra Pradesh. And we have been asking for that demand for the last 20 years. We have been very hopeful that this government is going to do justice on this, but they have kept back on that demand, madam. And another demand that we have, backward district funds, madam. Every year 50 crores for 7 districts in Andhra Pradesh, it has been promised. For 3 years they have given, madam, but the 4th year, since we started protesting against the NDA, but since we have started protesting, saying that this government is not doing anything, they have given 50 crores and they have taken it back, madam. It has never happened in the history of government of India, where they have given 350 crores to 7 districts to the government of state government, madam, and they have taken it back. What is the excuse they are giving, madam? They are saying that the state is not performing well. They are saying that there is a lot of corruption happening in the state. How can you speak like that when the very same central institutions which the central government is responsible of, they have given 600 awards to the performance of state government, saying that you are the best performing state in the country. I have the facts also, madam, I can lay it on the table. We are the number one, first state to be open defecation free, madam. We are the first state in the country to implement DDN, madam, for all 110 ULBs, madam. We are number 2 in the smart city implementation program, madam. Number 1 in the country in implementation of national urban livelihood division, madam. Number 1 in the country to develop app monitoring for anti-birth control and anti-rabies vaccine programs, madam. There are 600 these kind of programs where Andhra is leading the country. When the central institutions have said that your country, your state is performing so well, the Prime Minister, his honorable ministers, they all come and allege that there is a lot of corruption happening. When there is a lot of corruption happening, why don't you take action? Why don't you give proper details about what corruption is going on? Not a single allegation has been made with proof, madam. They are all false allegations. And this is the kind of leadership Prime Minister ji is promoting in this country, madam. Anyone who questions him, anyone who wants to ask him for something, anyone who is demanding, anyone who is asking for justice, he sends CBI, ED, IT to do. He uses those, misuses those institutions టూ అన్డెమోక్రాటిక్లీ మేడం. దిస్ ఇస్ టోటల్ ఫాసిజం మేడం, విచ్ హెస్ నెవర్ బీన్ దేర్ ఇన్ దిస్ కంట్రీ. అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ థింక్ దిస్ కంట్రీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు టాలరేట్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ లీడర్షిప్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ద కమింగ్ ఎలక్షన్స్. డెఫినెట్లీ ఐ హావ్ ద కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ దట్ దిస్ కంట్రీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు వోట్ అగేన్స్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డిక్టేటర్షిప్ ఆల్సో మేడం. అండ్ ది అదర్ డిమాండ్స్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ మేడం, స్టేట్ డిమాండ్స్, దెర్ ఇస్ ద డిమాండ్ ఆఫ్ అమరావతి ఆల్సో. యూ నో దట్ వీ ఆర్ బీన్ అ స్టేట్ which has been divided without any capital. We have to build our own capital. We have to compete with Hyderabad. We have to compete with Chennai. We have to compete with Karnataka's Bangalore. When we have no capital, how are we going to compete? Don't we have youth in our state? Don't we have to create the jobs for them? And unless we have a proper capital where we can invite investments into our state, how can we do it? And for that very reason, madam, a wonderful scheme of land pooling has been done by our Chandrababu Naidu Garu. He has brought in 33,000 acres. He has brought in from the farmers, madam. They have donated the land for the creation of such capital, madam. And the emotion that we have associated with Amaravati, they have insulted us, madam. Now, they have given us 1,500 crores for the completion of the capital. Whereas in Gujarat, they have constructed one statue of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. We are not against the construction of the statue. But what has happened? They have given 3,000 crores for the statue, which is being built in 50 to 100 acres. Now a capital which has to come up for the future of the state, which is going to be a lifeline of this country. How many crores they have given? 1,500 crores. When we ask for more, because we have to construct a capital, madam. If we have to compete with Hyderabad, the worth of Hyderabad is approximately 5 lakh crores today. When we have to compete with that kind of state, don't we have the right to have our own capital? You have given 1,500 crores and you are saying that you will build a capital with this? And 3 years back, madam, when Narendra Modi ji came to Amaravati to inaugurate, to lay the foundation stone of the capital, he has advised our chief minister, you please go to Kazakhstan, you see the Astana capital that is coming there, and you try to implement the same kind of strategies in Amaravati. How can you build Astana kind of capital with 1,500 crores? Please give us a plan also, Madam Speaker. We are requesting the central government to give a plan that with 1,500 crores we want to build a capital which is a world-class capital. I think we don't have that kind of strategies, Madam. I think Madam, if Narendra Modi ji has, we request that if he gives that kind of strategies for us, Madam. Other than that, the other one, Polavaram, madam. Polavaram is the lifeline of Andhra Pradesh. We want to make our state drought-free state. We want to make our state farmer-friendly state. For that, we want to create Polavaram. It is approximately 56,000 crores. And it is written in the AP Reorganization Act that it is going to be a national project, which means that the responsibility of the construction has been lined with the central government. And today, the state government has taken the responsibility of building the dam, madam. And now we are still having a pending budget of 4,000 crores which the central government has to give for Andhra Pradesh. And when we keep asking, they keep delaying, madam. Already it is a cash-ridden state. Already we are facing financial problems. When we want to hurry up with the construction of this, why isn't the central government supporting on an equal basis of giving funds for the Polavaram, madam? And there is no talk about steel plant. They don't talk about Duggirajapatnam port. They don't talk about Kakinada petrochemical complex. There are so many things that are still pending with the act, and the central government doesn't have any single right to say they have done justice for Andhra Pradesh, madam. I want this to go on record once again that they have not done anything. Not a single assurance has been fulfilled, madam, today. That is why we want to stand united in terms of opposition also, madam, because we have been cheated. We have been insulted. And now we want to go together to fight for the justice, and this kind of situation is not just happening with Andhra, madam. We have seen that this kind of justice is being happening with all states also. We have seen Bengal, we have seen Tamil Nadu, we have seen Uttar Pradesh. Wherever election comes up, these kind of strategies are being played. Opposition is being divided. CBI, ED, IT, these kinds of institutions are misused and they are sent on the opposition to kill the opposition, madam. It is not good for this democracy when a leader who has to lead this country where sabka saath, sabka vikas, jo baaton mein nahi, kaamon mein hona chahiye, wo nahi dikh raha, madam. Isi halat se hum bol rahe hain aaj. Or the other thing, madam, other than the state issues, there are lot of central issues also, madam. Coming back to the issue of farmers, they are trying to give 6,000 crores today. In terms of, they are giving 6,000 rupees per year, 2,000 in 3 installments. Why haven't they done it before, madam? Why do they have to do it just before the elections? Is the government not there for the last 4 years? Are the farmers not facing this kind of situation? Agriculture, madam, even the government is afraid to release the National Crime Record Bureau, which keeps a account of the committing of farmer suicides also, madam. They are afraid to release that kind of data. They are afraid to release the crime records. they are afraid to release the unemployment data, they are afraid to release any kind of economic survey reports, all kinds of reports they are trying to. Madam, 5 minutes, I am going to conclude, madam. So they want to push their own agenda and they want to suppress the truth, madam, and this is not the way Gandhiji wanted this country to be led, madam. And also other schemes like jobs, madam, just now I mentioned the NSSO report, it has also not come out because it is not favorable for the government. The unemployment today is in a 45-year high, 60-year high. Since independence, probably this is the highest that we have had because there was no count before. But this kind of situation, how it has to be dealt, there is nothing from the central government giving a direction on how to employ the youth of this country, madam. Other than this, madam, madam, 2 minutes, madam, इस टर्म का आखिरी स्पीच है मैडम. इतना हमने इतना एनर्जी खर्च किया मैडम, बाहर भी अंदर भी. आई विल जस्ट फिनिश इन 5 मिनट्स मैडम.
यू डिस्टर्ब द
आई विल फिनिश इन 5 मिनट्स. आर इंस्टीट्यूशंस आल्सो मैडम, कमिंग बैक टू द एपी रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन एक्ट, वी हैव बीन गिवन इंस्टीट्यूशन. Now the central government keeps saying that we have granted 11 institutions, and I also remind them that there are a couple of other institutions that need to be put up. There is one tribal university in Vijayanagaram also that needs to come up. But for institutions that they have kept, madam, the state government has given land. Unless the state government gives land, they can't put it up, madam. We have taken the responsibility of giving land, we have taken the responsibility of constructing the compound walls and everything. So approximately 12,000 crore worth of land has been given, madam, and another 12,000 crores is being required from the central government to construct these institutions. And in these 5 budgets that they have put up, including this vote on this interim budget they have put, madam, they have given total 745 crores in these 5 years. Now when are these institutions going to finish, madam? Is this the responsibility that they have in the state of Andhra Pradesh? These kind of issues are, lot of issues are pending, madam. That is why I want to ek kahawat sunana chahta hu, ek do teen line. Maine bhi thoda homework kiya madam, thoda ye baatein madam hamare purv pradhanmantri aadarniya Vajpayee ji ne bole the, madam. और बड़े गर्व के साथ मैं भी वो कहता हूँ, मैडम. क्या हार में क्या जीत में, किंचित नहीं भयभीत में, कर्तव्य पथ पर जो मिले ये भी सही वो भी सही, यही हमारा है मैडम. कर्तव्य आज वही है हमारा जो 2014 में था, 2019 में वही कर्तव्य के साथ आज बढ़ रहे. जो हमारे साथ मिले वो सही, जो ना मिले वो भी सही, मैडम. हम अपना कर्तव्य में लगे रहेंगे, हम इसके लिए लड़ते रहेंगे. एक और पंक्ति है मैडम, एक और अपने तेलुगु का महाकवि है मैडम, गुर्रजाड़ा अप्पाराव, उन्होंने भी एक अच्छी बात बोली है मैडम, वो तेलुगु में है, मैं ट्रांसलेट भी कर दूंगा ताकि सबको समझ में भी आए. దేశమును ప్రేమించమన్న మంచి అన్నది పెంచమన్న ఒట్టి మాటలు కట్టిపెట్టోయ్ గట్టి మేల్తల పెట్టవోయ్ సొంత లాభము కొంతమాను పొరుగు వాడికి తోడుపడవోయ్ దేశమంటే మట్టి కాదోయ్ దేశమంటే మనుషులోయ్. దిస్ ఇస్ జస్ట్ ఫర్ ద సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ అండ్ ఆర్ ఆనరబుల్ ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ నరేంద్ర మోదీజీ మేడం. ది ట్రాన్స్లేట్స్ టు లవ్ యువర్ కంట్రీ, వైడ్ అండ్ గుడ్ థింగ్స్, స్టాప్ షాలో టాక్, థింక్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రాంగ్ హెల్ప్, బీ యూస్ఫుల్ టు ది అదర్ మ్యాన్ విత్ అ బిట్ మోర్ ఆఫ్ సెల్ఫ్లెస్నెస్. Country is not just the mud and soil. Country is about people, madam. It's about people. I hope the government realizes this and it takes in the sentiments of this. And I hope the Narendra Modi ji, जो मन की बात करते रहते हैं, जन की बात भी थोड़ा सुने, और वो जो सवाल पूछते रहते हैं इस देश को कि हाउस द जोश, थोड़ा भी ख्याल रखे कि इस देश का होश कैसा है. अगर उसका जो सोच अगर करेंगे तो थोड़ा सा ध्यान में आएगा. थैंक यू वेरी मच मैडम, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
Subscribe us and press the bell icon for more interesting updates.